I'd like to show you how to calculate first and follow sets. We have those grammar given where there isn't set which the start symbol is, but in our cases it's always the S. So let me give you an example derivation first, or an example tree of a word. We start with the starting symbol, then it derives to first we take the first rule maybe, and this B maybe goes to B, and the A derives to S. And now let's take the second rule, so let S goes to B and A, and the B maybe goes to small b. So first I want to calculate the first set of B. And the first set that are all symbols that are terminals and that are leftmost under this variable in a tree, or leftmost and after that in a derivation. So the first set of B, you could also have a look just at the grammar. In the first set of B, you have so small b, and you have this string, the empty string epsilon. So, and as you can see here, there are no other possibilities that for terminals that can be derived from the b at the first place. So next, I want to calculate the first set of S. And now you see why I had to do B first, because as you can see here, the first terminal that is leftmost under the S could be something that is derived from the B. So we have in one case the small b. And now B can be derived to epsilon, and if that happens, let me show you it at the derivation. If we do something like this and B derives to epsilon, then the first terminal under the S will be an A and no epsilon. So epsilon is in the first set of B, but not in the first set of S. But A is here, because those A, or you can have a look here, if the B becomes an empty string, then the A will be at the first place. Or another way to get those A would be to have a look at those first rule where the S goes to terminal A and whatever. So you have B and A in the first set of S. Now I want to do the first set for A. And as you can see right here, because we have this chain rule A goes to S, everything that is in the first set of S will also be in the first set of A. So because A just derives to S and nothing else, so you have B and A as well in the first set of A because of this chain rule. So we have calculated all the first rules of the left side of the rules. Now we calculate the first sets of the right side. So first I take this, I want to find the first set of that part, and that is an easy one because the only terminal that could be leftmost at this string is a small a. Now we take the second one, first of BA. Now you have the same case as we had here, because either the variable b goes to a terminal b, then you would have b at the first place in this string, or if the b derives to the empty string, then you would have those a at the first place. So now we don't need to write down the first set of s because we already did it. We need the first sets of this one, and that they are easy too, because at those right side of the rules there are only terminals, so the first set will be those single terminal. And first off, epsilon is nothing but epsilon. Now, next we want to calculate the follow sets. And let me explain to you what follow is. As you maybe see here, you can see that in this tree, the B, the big B, the capital B, will be followed by an A. Or you can see it in this rule. This B is followed by an A in the string, in those grammar. And that is in... Yeah, let's see if that is the case in all cases. First, I want to calculate the follow set of S. Now we have an important case, because as you can see, S is a starting symbol. So S will be followed by the end of the word. And we mark the end of the word by those dollar sign. So in the follow set of the starting symbol, there's always those word end, or string end sign. And as you see in this part of the tree, the S can be followed. So the orange part is what's under the S. It's not what follows the S. But those small b follows the s, and because it stands after the s. And again, we only want to have terminals in the set, in the follow set. So you could also see it in the grammar, but I think it's a little bit hard, because this S will have the same follow set as the A, and the A is appears in this right side of the rule, and here the A can be followed by a B. And if the B becomes epsilon, then you again have those word end sign. And but if the b derives to a small b, then those s will be followed by those b. So all we have in the follow set of s is dollar and b. Now I want to do the follow set of a. And because of those chain rule, everything that follows the s also follows the a. Not exactly, I guess. I guess it would be the other round. Everything that follows the A also follows the S. But as you can see here, in this case it's the same. The A can be either followed by those B, by a small b, because in this rule you have the capital B following the A. Or if the B derives to epsilon, then you will have the word end sign after A. So, and last but not least, we calculate the follow set of B. Unless have a look where the bee is appears in this rules. In this case, as you can see here, the bee is followed by a terminal A, so we don't have to look any further. And in this case, the bee is at the end of a rule that derives from the starting symbol. So after the bee, you can have the end of the word. That is those dollar sign. So now we calculated the first and the follow sets. And there's another question. Is this grammar a LL1 grammar? And that I will answer in another video.